Welcome to MooMooMath and comparing rational numbers. What is a rational number? A rational number is any number that can be written as a fraction or a ratio. When the fraction is divided out, it becomes a terminating or repeating decimals. Here are some examples of rational numbers. 6 equals 6 over 1. Negative 3, negative 3 over 1. 1/2 is 0.5. On the other hand, irrational numbers are non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. For example, the square root of 2 is this repeating decimal. The following symbols are used to compare rational numbers. This symbol equals less than. 5 is less than 7. I remember this because the smaller end is facing the smaller number. This symbol is greater than. 7 is greater than 5. Notice that the larger end of the symbol is facing the larger number. And finally, this symbol is equal. 5 is equal to 5. In this video, I'm going to talk about ordering and comparing rational numbers. And there's a couple steps you can go through in order to help this help you compare the rational numbers. Step one is you should plot the numbers on a number line. Two, you can compare the positions of the numbers on the number line. To the left, the numbers are less than the numbers on the right. And then if you're comparing the numbers, use the appropriate symbol, less than, greater than, or equal, and write a solution. Or you can, if you're ordering the numbers, you can write them in order. The least will be the furthest to the left on the number line, and the greatest will be to the right. Okay, so let's go ahead and work an example and apply these rules. I went ahead and created a little number line so to speed things up. It says, at midnight, the temperature at the ski resort was negative 9 5/8 degrees Fahrenheit. At sunrise, the temperature was negative 2.8 degrees Fahrenheit. Use symbols to compare the temperatures. Was it warmer at midnight or at sunrise? So first thing we're going to do is we're going to plot the numbers. And so I will first plot negative 9.58, and I have negative 10 on this side and 0 on this side. I have negative 9.5, which is halfway in between, and I know that negative 5.8 is slightly larger than 9.5 because 4/8 is 1/2. So I'm going to plot negative 9.58 here, and let's use a different color pen. So that is negative 9 5/8, and then I'm going to plot negative 2.8. And 2.8 is almost 3. Here is halfway, so negative 2.8 will be here. So that would be negative 2.8. Okay, so what I do next is I know that the number on the left is less than the number on the right. So I can rewrite that as, and I'll write this down here at the very bottom, I can write that negative 9 5/8 is less than negative 2.8. And so was it warmer at midnight or sunrise? It was warmer at sunrise because it was 2.8, and 2.8 is greater than negative 9.58. Okay, there's one example. Let's look at another example here. And it says, order from least to greatest, negative 1 3/4, 2.6, and negative 2.6 and negative 4.3. So let's go ahead, and the first thing we do is plot them on the number line. Negative 1 3/4, I have 0 to negative 5, so negative 1.5 is here. I know that negative 3/4 is the equivalent to negative 1.75. So I will plot this right here, and I'll go ahead and write it. So this is negative 1 3/4. Okay. And then negative 2.6 There is negative 2.5, so negative 2.6 will be right here. And finally, we have negative 4.3, and this is negative 4.5, so negative 4.3 will be somewhere in between there. So that is negative 4.3. Again, the numbers on the left are smaller than the numbers on the right, so I can rewrite that as negative 4.3, and then negative 2.6, and negative 1 3/4. Again, what I've done, I've placed them on the number line. Numbers to the left are smaller than numbers on the right. And finally, what if you have a number like this? You have negative 5 3/4 and negative 5 1/3. So how do we determine which one is smaller or larger? What you can do is create two number lines. And let me get another one that's a little bit neater. So what you can do is draw two number lines and then compare them. Let me set up the example and I think it will make sense to you. So I have two number lines between negative 6 and negative 5. And this first one, I have divided it in fraction form. And you'll notice that the midpoint is negative 5 1/2. So it goes negative 5 3/4, negative 5 1/2, negative 5 1/4. So I will plot negative 5 3/4 right here. Okay. Now, below that, since it was in tenths, I divided it into 10 equal sections. Okay. This one, I used the bottom, denominator to tell me how many places to divide this interval into. So since it was 4 on the bottom, I divided it into 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is 10, so I would divide it into 10 equal sections. Technically, I should count it 1, 2, 3, 4. Those are my 4 equal sections. And this has 10 equal sections, so I will do negative 5 1/3. And so there's negative 5, negative 5.5, negative 5.4, negative 5.3 is here. I then look at them. The number on the left will be smaller than the number on the right. So negative 5 3/4 will be less than negative 5.3. Okay? And finally, let's do one more example like that. Again, what I have is I have two numbers, negative 2.7 and negative 2.56. I will draw two fractions, and I went ahead and did this ahead of time. I know whenever I have tenths, I'm going to divide it into 10 equal sections. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 equal sections. 2.7 will be, here's 2.5, 2.6, 2.7 is here. So that is negative 2.7. And then the denominator gives me a clue as to how many sections to divide this section into. And that is 6. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I will plot 2 5/6. Here is 2 3/6, 2 4/6. And so this would be negative 2 5/6. So it is further to the left than negative 2.7. So I will rewrite it like this. Negative 2 5/6 is less than negative 2.7. Hope that helps in comparing rational numbers. Thanks for watching. MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day.